Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will show you how to use UFile online to prepare your tax return. I've made another video using Wealthsimple Tax. If you're interested, you can take a look to see which software you prefer. I always start by reviewing my notice of assessment from the prior year to see if I have any carry forward amount. For example, LLSP contribution limit and unused tuition amounts. In addition to T4, T3, T5, you may also have receipts for medical expenses, donations, home office expenses, etc. The First Home Savings Account, FHSA, is a new registered plan to help first-time home buyers save for their first home. Your FHSA issuer will give you a T4 FHSA slip. Please keep your supporting documents for at least 6 years. The first step is to log into UFile online. If you don't have an account, you will have to create a new account. After you log into UFile, you can click on the Go icon to create a new file for the 2023 tax year. I already created a file, so I'm just going to click Launch to open the 2023 tax file. You just have to go through the questions one by one in order to prepare your tax return. You can use the navigation panel on the left side to go to different pages. The first page is for the identification information. Enter your name, social insurance number, and date of birth. The net file access code is an 8-character code located on your notice of assessment for the previous tax year. It is intended to be used as an extra level of security. If this is the first time you file your tax return, you don't have to enter this. This field is optional. Then enter your province or territory of residence on December 31st, 2023. Next, enter your marital status, whether your status has changed in 2023, and your gender, and click Next. For the information for the spouse, usually we put in complete information, unless for special situations. For example, if the spouse is a non-resident who doesn't have to file a tax return, then we can select net income only. For this example, we will choose complete information. Click Next. We have to put in the mailing address. If you moved it in 2023 from one province or territory to another, you have to put in the date of your move. Confirm whether your home address is the same as your mailing address, and put in your telephone number. Click Next. We have to answer some CRA questions, such as the language of the tax return. Are you filing the tax return for the very first time? Did you own any specified foreign property in 2023 with a total cost over 100,000 Canadian dollars? If the answer to this question is yes, or if you are not sure, I wouldn't recommend you to do your tax return yourself, especially if this is the first time you are doing the tax return yourself. This is because the rules for foreign property T1135 reporting are very complex. Did you sell a principal residence in 2023? Are you an officer or a servant of another country, such as diplomat, or a family member or an employee of such person? Do you have Canadian citizenship? For the purpose of the Climate Action Incentive Payment, we have to specify the area that we live in. For the email notifications from the CRA, If you prefer to receive your notifications and documents through email, then you can select Yes and put in your email address. There is a new question this year. Do you have a foreign mailing address on file with the CRA? After you answer all the questions, click Next. For the NetFile question, will you be using NetFile to submit your federal return electronically? This means, do you want to file your tax return electronically to the CRA? I'm going to choose Yes if eligible. Will you be using NetFile to submit a prior year federal return today or within the next 2 days? We'll choose No here. If you intend to file your prior year's return, please file your returns in order, meaning the oldest return first. This is because any prior year amounts could potentially impact your current year amounts. Click Next. For the CRA autofill my return, if you have a CRA My account, this optional function allows you to download into UFile the information that the CRA has available, so that you don't have to enter all the information manually. If you're using this function, it is still important to check the information with your supporting documents, just to make sure that all the information is downloaded properly and completely. The CRA does not have all the information, such as donation receipts, medical expenses, home office expenses, etc. You will still need to enter this manually. With the Express Notice of Assessment, you can get your Notice of Assessment right after you file your tax return. You must be registered with the CRA My account in order to use the Express NOA. Next, we'll complete the interview setup. Check all the boxes that are relevant for you. For this video, I will select the following: employment income, employment expenses, interest, medical expenses, donations, and RRSP. The first home savings account, FHSA, is a new registered plan to help first-time home buyers save for their first home. Your FHSA issuer will give you a T4 FHSA slip showing the totals of the transactions you made in your FHSA for the year. For residency status, it is important to recognize that residency status for income tax purposes is not the same as residency status for immigration purposes. This question is related to residency status for income tax purposes. If you become a resident of Canada for income tax purposes in 2023, you'll need to enter your date of entry and your income earned while you were a non-resident. The income earned as a non-resident before moving to Canada is non-taxable, except for income you received from Canadian source. Income earned as a non-resident is required to calculate certain benefits and credits. If you're not sure about your residency status for income tax purposes, I would recommend you to please consult with a professional. Once you have checked all the boxes that are relevant for you, click Next. The navigation panel on the left has been updated to show the pages that you just selected. We'll go to T4 and employment income and click on the plus icon next to T4 income. You will need to enter all the information as per your T4 tax slip, such as employer's name, employment income, province or territory of employment, your CPP contributions, your EI contributions, income tax deducted, etc. In 2023, employers need to report on a T4 whether an employee or any of their family members were eligible to access any dental care insurance or coverage of dental services of any kind offered by the employer. This new information is reported in Box 45, Employer Offered Dental Benefits on the T4. Once you're done entering all the information, double check the information just to make sure that you enter everything accurately. Then you can click Next. If you have more than one T4, you can just go back to the T4 and Employment Income section and click on the plus icon again to open a new page to enter the information from your other T4 tax slip. Next, assume I worked from home in 2023, and assume I met the CRA criteria for using the detailed method to claim home office expenses. We'll go to Employment Expenses section. Choose the option that is relevant for you. For this example, I'm going to use T777, Eligible Employment Expenses for an Employee Earning a Salary. Remember, you need supporting documents and a signed T2200 from your employer in order to use the detailed method. Enter the information for your employer and enter your information as well. Then go to the Home Office Expenses page and enter all the relevant information. To calculate the percentage of your home used for employment purposes, use a reasonable basis. If you don't know how to do this calculation, you can refer to the CRA website for details. Once you've entered all the relevant information, click Next. If your employer has already completed Form T2200 for you do not need to fill it out here. You do not have to submit Form T2200 with your tax return. However, the CRA may ask to see it later. Click Next. Next, we'll look at interest and investment income. Again, just click on the plus icon to open a page to enter the information based on your T5 tax slip. If it is a joint account, then you have to put in the percentage you're entitled to. For this example, I'm going to assume I earned interest income. Interest income is reported in box 13. Once you're done entering all the information on your tax slip, click Next. Next, we'll look at RRSP. For the RRSP, you have to enter your RRSP deduction limit for 2023. You can find this information on your 2022 notice of assessment. I'm just going to assume that my deduction limit was 2000 and the contribution that I made in 2023 was also 2000. You can choose whether to use all of your RRSP deduction in the current year or save all or some to future years. For this example, I'm going to use all the deductions in 2023. Click Next. Next, we'll look at donations. Go to the Donations Political Contributions page. Choose the type of donations. For this example, I'm going to choose Canadian Charitable Donations. Enter the organization name and the donation amount. Also, specify the nature of the donation. Click Next. For the medical expenses, we just need to enter the date and also a description of the medical expenses. For this example, I just assume that I purchased a pair of glasses for $500 on June 1st, 2023. If you have more than one medical expenses, you can click on the plus icon and enter the information from all of your receipts. Click Next. For medical expenses, to qualify for the tax credit, your medical expenses must be more than the lesser of 3% of your 2023 net income, or $2,635. If you're not sure, just enter all of your expenses into the software. The software would determine whether you're eligible for the medical expenses tax credit. If you have a spouse or common law partner and you would like to prepare your tax returns together, you can add a spouse or common law partner. The questions are basically the same, such as identification, address, CRA questions, etc. If you have dependents, you can add a dependent by clicking the Add Dependent icon and then just follow the instructions and answer the questions. Once you are done entering all the information, you can click Review in order to review the information. Based on the information entered, the software calculates the refund or balance owing. It will also calculate the amount of non-refundable or refundable tax credits. It is a good habit to review the errors, warnings, and tips section. You can also look at the tax saving ideas to see if there are any tax savings recommendations. You can go to the Federal tab in order to see the summary of the tax information. After you review the information, you can go to the tax return page to download the tax file. I'm not able to do this as I haven't paid for my tax return and I'm not eligible for the free version. There are many CRA certified software nowadays. Some are free, some are not, and you can choose the one that best meets your needs. When you are ready to file your tax return, you can go to the Net File page to file your tax return. You will get the confirmation number from the CRA for each tax return. Please keep this for your record. Thank you so much for watching.